opportunity of the governor appointing Jim Sherry as director recently, and his goal and everybody's goal in the office is, of course, everything that's going on with the terror threats, to make sure that the community is aware of, and all communities are aware that not only the local city agencies such as the NYPD and other agencies are interacting with what's going on a daily basis, that Office of Homeland Security has a vital role of being involved and making sure that all the agencies coordinating on the state level, from the governor's office and down, making sure that the communities are protected. So I'll give it back to the director for now, and then we'll...
From the FBI, I retired from the FBI in October after 21 years. 14 of those years were spent in New York and Manhattan. 10 of those years were spent on the JTTF, the Joint Terrorism Task Force. In 2004, I left Manhattan and went to FBI headquarters, where I was assigned to what's called Counterterrorism Watch. It's a massive center that collects information, intelligence, and then analyzes it, does threat resolution, threat mitigation for all U.S. interests in the U.S. and outside of the U.S. And then for my last year at FBI headquarters, I was assigned to what's called the National Counterterrorism Center, which is a phenomenal organization that came about because of the September 11th. At the National Counterterrorism Center, you have 16 members of the intelligence community represented every day, day in, day out. So as an American, it's very gratifying to see that all the entire intelligence community, including law enforcement, is together under one roof, in one place, keeping this country safe. So there's a lot to talk about, but there's a brief summary here that we came up with, just to give you an idea of the difference between around 17 years ago and what's happening today. In 1993, the World Trade Center was attacked, okay? In 1998, two U.S. embassies in Africa were bombed. 227 people were killed. And then in 2000, the USS Cole was attacked off the coast of Yemen. And then September 11th happened. So there are four or five different attacks, plots, during the course of one decade. To fast forward to post 9/11, we've had around 30 plots in the U.S. alone since 9/11. Okay, eight major Homeland plots in 2009 alone. Okay, we had the the Christmas Day event on the plane going into
underwear
Detroit.
Bomber. 25th.
Yes, I refer to them as the brief bomber.
Yeah, the brief bomber.
That's okay. The underwear bomber. We have a homegrown jihadist coming out of Philadelphia, known as Jihad Jane. Okay, so we have a lot of people here in this this country, and coming in from overseas, who are intending to do us harm. And we don't have to look much farther than 1 week ago, 6 days ago, and go over to Times Square to see that this threat is real. It's here. I regret to say it's here to stay. I think Al Qaeda and its affiliates are going to take two tacks. One is the smaller plots, the plots involving one or two or five individuals with a car bomb or multiple. Having dealt with terrorism throughout the 1990s, I don't have a crystal ball, but I can stand here today and know in my heart that Al Qaeda is here to stay. Al Qaeda and its affiliates are here to stay. They're going to carry out smaller plots. They're going to eventually get back to what they love to do, which is the spectacular plot. There's no doubt in my mind. It's just the matter of time. It's up to all of us in this room and outside this room, and the law enforcement and intelligence community, to remain vigilant and to not become complacent. If you see something, say something, just ask the vendor on 45th and Broadway how that policy works. I will take questions afterwards, but I know we only have about an hour today. If anyone ever wants a current threat briefing in your local community, I'd be happy to come out along with my team to do that for the community.
Jim,
yes,
just a
sir.
Quick...